Robert William Gunner. How's your day going?
Good.
About to get a lot better. You take this woman, Lisa, to be your lawfully wedded wife. To have, to hold, for better or worse, in sickness and in health, for as long as you both shall live. Lisa Marie, do you take this man, Gunner, to be your lawfully wedded husband? To have, to hold, for better, for worse, in sickness and health, for as long as you both shall live.
I've been waiting for this day for the past 7 years, and you look more amazing than I could ever imagine. It's crazy to think that we're standing here when you said no the first time I asked you to be my girlfriend, but here we are 7 years later with a relationship that we built so strong that we can make it past any obstacle along the way. You know I don't believe in soulmates because I think it's more beautiful of a concept when two people work together to mold a perfect relationship, not when the pieces just magically fit together. I appreciate you so much. You inspire me to be the best man I can be, and I promise to be a loving, supportive husband and father when the time comes. I love you so much. I can't wait for all of our future adventures together, and I promise to fill it with as much fun, excitement, goofiness, and most importantly, love.
I promise to always save you the last sips of my pop when it's watered down just how you like it. To always give up the window seat on every plane we venture out with. That maybe would be more for me than you, but it's okay. Give you all the cheese off my tacos if in exchange you give me your tomato. To make you my forever coffee date until we're inevitably drinking decaf in the afternoon watches The Price is Right, since we definitely don't do that now. I promise to be your back scratcher, terrible storyteller, and backseat driver so as long as I shall live. If in return you save me all the middle slices of pizza, never get tired of me asking for chocolate milk late at night because you make it better, and support me buying things that I don't need just because I have a coupon or they're on sale. I'm so grateful that you helped me pick up quarters that I dropped in TikTok nearly 10 years ago. My whole life changed when I met you. All jokes aside, I'm proud to carry your family's last name as my own and begin building a family with you in which we are equals. But I acknowledge that we will not always be. We talk about the balance of our relationship often. Some days I know you'll only be able to give 30% to her whole, and that's okay. I vow to be the 70% that we need to make it through, because that's what this partnership is. And I know you will continue to be the bigger half of our balance when I need the help too, because you have already shown me over and over again that you will always dust me off and carry me when I need it most. With you I found purpose, and I found love. You pushed me to be the best I could. You make me better than I was yesterday, and because of you, I am more patient, I am more kind, and I am happier than most. I acknowledge that what we have is rare, and I promise to never take that for granted from this day forward. My love to you is full path.
No, there's nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love.
Thank you.
And who gives this woman's hand to this young man?
Mother, mother.
Welcome, friends, family, loved ones, to this special day that Gunnar and Lisa have chosen to share with us. My name is Tony, and I am honored that I have been chosen to pastor this wedding. Let's share in the joy of this day and what this day means. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this day, for your servants, Gunnar and Lisa, for their life that they share together. Lord, the love that they share is learned and reflected from the love that you have for us. God, for those of us that know and love them, may we share in their joy. Give them comfort and love. This journey is not an easy one. There will be challenges, to be sure. But guided by your embrace and your love, Lord, we ask that we can celebrate this day as well as be there as friends and guides. And just thank you for everything that this day means, everything that comes after it. I pray this in your name. Amen. You may be seated. All right, let's get this silly part over with. If there is anyone who has just cause why these two should not be united in the holy sacrament of matrimony, let that party speak now, or forever hold your peace. And to the surprise of absolutely no one, there was no protest, because, like the audience in the Song of Solomon that sees a couple that God has brought together, we too recognize this union as being created by God, and we celebrate it. God intends marriage as a union, a promise, a relationship that includes him. God brought the two of you together and is at the very center of this union. Marriage is an example of what is called a covenant, which in Bible times was a big deal, very often used when neighboring kingdoms were forming an alliance and they wanted to be sure that neither one would back out on the deal. So a covenant was more than just any ordinary promise. It was basically a way of saying, I'm so serious about this promise that I am all in, even if you are not. That's how serious my devotion is. That is what a covenant is. And all too often, our culture mistakes marriage to be just another relationship. And that is why, when you watch Hallmark movies or romantic movies, they always end how? They always end with the couple getting married. The end! It always bothered me. Because marriage is not the end, but rather the beginning. You two have been with each other for a very long time. And yet, I tell you that even now, with all the good times that you have shared, with the memories that you have crafted, your life together is just starting. There is so much yet to come. The book of Proverbs is written by King Solomon, the wisest man who ever lived. In this book, he draws distinctions between wise choices and foolish choices. And these choices determine the path that our life will take. The final chapter of this book is sometimes called The Worthy Woman. We see the image of a woman filled with wisdom, and we see her husband, who has made the wise choice to be with her, and he realizes how blessed he is to have her. I'll read now from the Holy Scriptures written in the book of Proverbs. I'm in chapter 31, verse 10. A worthy woman who can find, she is far more worthy than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her. He will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She looks for wool and flax and works with her hands in delight. She is like the merchant ships. She brings her food from afar. She rises also while it is still night and gives food to her household. and portion state remains. She considers a field and buys it. From her earnings, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She senses that her gain is good. Her lamp does not go out at night. Skipping ahead to verse 28. Her children rise up and bless her, her husband also, and he praises her, saying, "Many daughters have done nobly, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty vain, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the product of her hands, and let her works be praised in the gates." Anyone who knows the two of you knows that God has you meant for each other. I know it sounds cliche, oh, you two are made for each other, but think about the weight of that statement. The creator of the universe decided to be born as a human being, suffered, died, and resurrected for us, and one day is coming again to reform the world in a new kingdom. That being really likes the fact that you're together and wants you to have a prosperous marriage. That's something that we should celebrate. Let's be grateful for that as we celebrate the integration of our of your lives. And to demonstrate that, we have two cans of soil. One is from your family's land, correct, and one is from yours. Have you ever combined two different types of soil and then tried to separate them again? You can't do it. The soils have been blended. They have been combined. They are now one soil. And that is your marriage. That's how marriage works. And now we'll see that in a metaphorical image. We're going to demonstrate. Like your life will grow in the combination of the two sides. The two soils can't ever be separated. We will now listen to a reading from the classic story, The Little Prince, as chosen by the couple. Yes.
Hello, everyone. My name is Kyle, and what does that mean, to tame? It is an act too often neglected, said the fox. It means to establish ties. Go and look again at the roses. You will understand now that yours is unique in all the world. Then come back to say goodbye to me, and I will make you a present of the secret. The little prince went away to look again at the roses. You are not at all like my rose, he said. As yet you are nothing. No one has tamed you. And you have tamed no one. You are like my fox when I first knew him. He was only a fox like 100,000 other foxes. But I have made him my friend, and now he is unique in all the world. And the roses were very much embarrassed. You are beautiful, but you are empty, he went on. One could not die for you. To be sure, an ordinary passerby would think that my rose looked just like you, the rose that belongs to me. But in herself alone, she is more important than all the hundreds of you other roses, because it is she that I have watered, because it is she that I have put under the glass globe, because it is she that I have sheltered behind the screen, because it is for her that I have killed the caterpillars, except for the ones that I have saved to become butterflies, because it is she that I have listened to when she grumbled or boasted, or even sometimes when she said nothing, because she is my rose. And he went back to meet the fox. Good Goodbye, he said. Goodbye, said the fox. And now here is my secret, a very simple secret. It is only with the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the eye. What is essential is invisible to the eye, the little prince repeated, so that he would be sure to remember. It is the time you have wasted for your rose that makes your rose so important. It is the time I have wasted for my rose, said the little prince, so that he would be sure to remember. Men have forgotten this truth, said the fox, but you must not forget it. You become responsible forever for what you have tamed. You are responsible for your rose. I am responsible for my rose, the little prince repeated, so he let you be sure to remember.
At this time, I will now ask you to take responsibility for your rose. Mr. Joe, do we have the rings? Worried me for a second there, Joe. Robert William Gunner. How's your day going?
Good.
It's about to get a lot better. Do you take this woman, Lisa, to be your lawfully wedded wife? To have, to hold, for better or worse, in sickness and in health, for as long as you both shall live. Lisa Marie, do you take this man, Gunner, to be your lawfully wedded husband? To have, to hold, for better, for worse, in sickness and health, for as long as you both shall live. And I will ask Gunner if he will gift Lisa with the ring. Lisa, would you gift Gunner with the ring? And by the grace of the Holy Spirit, and by the power invested in me by the state of Ohio, I pronounce you husband and wife. Gunner, I don't think I gotta tell you the part that comes next.
And then
glass is empty. That sucks.
So if you're too school for cool,
I mean,
and you treat it like a fool, you can choose to let it go. We can always party on our own.
So raise your
only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love.
I won't take long and take up too much time, but I do want to say a little something about Lisa. Lisa, you've been a perfect little sister in so many ways. So many laughs together, whether it be riding a bike straight into Daddy's monster truck, or you thinking it was so cute wrapping the meat around the rack of ribs. Being your sister has shaped me into the mother that I've become today. With being 5 years apart, you were the first real baby doll that I had, the first best friend, my first enemy. And before I realized it, you became my first role model. The way that you buckled down when you went through college, each time being on the dean's list, surprised me more and more each time we talked. Though we were far away, we were close in heart. That's when I realized that you were growing into a darn good woman, and you may be my baby sister, but I look up to you. As I was writing this, I was trying to think of some appropriate advice to give to you that isn't the normal, never go to bed mad, or happy wife, happy life. So I'll simply say that marriage is not 50% from a husband and 50% from a wife, but is 100% of each of you all the time. That way that you are able to hold each other up and be each other's stable partner. You two are thoughtful, loving, and very smart individuals, and I know that you will make an amazing couple. Remember, we will love you whether you are both 3 miles away from us or 13 hours and 49 minutes away. Congratulations.
Thank you. Alright, so it seems I left my speech out in the locker room. I'm a little speechless here tonight, alright? No, I'm just kidding. But, new to you that don't know me, I'm one of Gunner's closest friends, and I'm also Lisa's cousin. I've known Gunner for quite some time, and let me tell you, he's one of the most caring and selfless people I've ever met in my life. The first time me and Gunner were supposed to hang out, I got a call from him. He didn't want to come over, he said he felt sick. So I was like, alright, so 14, 15 at the time, I thought he was hit one of the guns or whatever. A couple days later, get a phone call and he had to get his appendix out because it burst. He was in the hospital all weekend. But being Lisa's cousin, I got to be there for almost all of their relationship. We'd always hang out whenever we were kids, and back then you could tell that these two people were meant to be together. They were some of the happiest people that I've ever seen. And I'm so happy for both of you, and I'm glad that I can be standing here tonight celebrating this day with you and the love that you guys share. So let's raise our glasses to Lisa and Gunner and wish them good luck on this journey that they're about to embark upon. Lisa and Gunner.
For I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with
you. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful evening. We thank you for Gunner and Lisa on their marriage. We thank you for all friends and family that are here tonight. We thank you, dear Lord, for all the blessings that you give us and pour out on all of us, and for just such a beautiful, beautiful evening. We pray, dear God, that you would bless this food that we're about to eat, that would nourish our bodies and give us strength. And we thank you for all our blessings. And we pray this all in our Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Little white flowers all up in her hair. Walk me down the aisle, Daddy. It's just about time. Does my wedding gown look pretty, Daddy? Daddy, don't cry. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something. Deserve her love every morning and butterfly kisses. I couldn't ask God for more. Man, this is what love is. I know I've gotta let her go, but I'll always remember every hug in the morning and butterfly kisses.
Young. I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night.
Tonight's the night, let's live it up. I got my money, let's spin it up. Go out and smash it, like oh my god. Jump off that sofa, let's kick it off. Fill up my cup, mazel tov. Look at her dancing, just take it off. Let's paint the town, we'll shut it down. Let's burn the roof,
and then we'll do it again.
Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it. And do it, and do it,
let's live it up.
And do it, and do it, and do it, do it, do it. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it. Cause I got a feeling, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling.
Bridesmaids against their groomsmen. Whoever comes back with the most money collected decides what the opposite sex does a shot of. So, yes, you got one song and one song only. It starts now.
Thank you. don't take my whiskey to extremes. Don't believe in chasing crazy dreams. My feet are planted firmly on the ground. But darling, when you come around, I get carried away by the look, by the light in your eyes, before I even realize the ride I'm on. Baby, I'm long gone. I get carried away, nothing matters but being with you. Like a feather flying high up in the sky on a windy day, I get carried away.